I'm Joe Gitter, a test cook at America's Test Kitchen, and we've teamed up with the Museum of Science in Boston to talk fermentation. In cooking, fermentation is defined as the controlled transformation of a food or beverage using microorganisms. One of the simplest ferments is delicious, easy sauerkraut. This age-old method not only enhances flavor, it also helps with food sustainability. Making sauerkraut is super satisfying, and it can extend the life of our cabbage. And that reduces food waste, which is such an important part of food sustainability. To make sauerkraut, all you need is a head of cabbage, some salt, and thyme. You can use red or green cabbage. First, you'll quarter and core a medium head of cabbage. Now, the core is very tough. It's too crunchy to enjoy, so we'll compost that. Then, shred your cabbage. You're looking for pieces about the width of a quarter. It's an eighth of an inch. In a large bowl, add 4 teaspoons of pickling salt. You can also use kosher salt, but as that's fluffier and less dense, you'll have to use about double the volume. Now for the fun bit. Roll up your sleeves and give the cabbage a good old massage. The massaging action breaks up the cell walls of the cabbage, which will help release its water and make it more tender. The salt that we added earlier is hygroscopic, which means it attracts water, so that also draws out the cabbage's juices. Stir in 1.5 teaspoons of juniper berries. Now this is just for flavor. You could have mustard seed, coriander seed, caraway seed, dill, or even an apple. In addition to being sustainable, homemade sauerkraut is super customizable. Transfer the cabbage to a container and press it down so that it sits below the water level. Cover the cabbage with parchment and weigh it down with a heavy object. I'm using a meat pounder, but you could easily use a can of beans or even a mason jar filled with water. By fermenting the cabbage under liquid, we've reduced its exposure to air to help prevent spoilage. Harmful molds need oxygen to survive. Cover it with some cheesecloth or a coffee filter so no bugs can get in, and then let it ferment in a cool place, but not the fridge, for 6 days. After 6 days, taste your sauerkraut. It'll have picked up lots of new flavors as well as becoming more sour. The longer you leave it, the more sour it becomes. If you're satisfied with the taste, transfer it to the fridge where fermentation will slow. Microbes thrive in warmer environments. On one level, all we've done is combine cabbage with salt and let it sit for almost a week. But on another level, we've completely controlled the entire environment so that a certain microorganism can flourish. This is all about lactic acid bacteria munching away on the natural sugars found in cabbage. This creates lactic acid, which lowers the pH, and that helps to preserve the cabbage. Where did this lactic acid bacteria come from? It's everywhere, in the air, on your hands, and on the cabbage. Unlike lots of bad bacteria and mold, lactic acid bacteria can thrive in salty environments. So we've got rid of the baddies and kept the goodies. A fresh head of cabbage lasts for maybe a week or two in the fridge, but thanks to the lactic acid, sauerkraut lasts for at least 6 weeks. And that helps cut down on food waste. And we've actually increased the healthfulness of the cabbage. Eating fermented foods is good for the health of your gut microbiome. People like to use sauerkraut as a side for a sausage, a filling in a sandwich, but my favorite use is as a crunchy, tangy topping to avocado toast. It's crunchy, but still tender. It's a little bit sweet, a little bit sour, and you get that herbaceousness from the juniper berries. It's delicious. Try making sauerkraut at home, and you'll be well on your way to healthy, sustainable food in almost no time. To get this recipe and more, check out americastestkitchen.com. Go to mos.org/earthshot and head to the Museum of Science in Boston to learn more about living sustainably.